For some reason, I get the feeling that today's gonna be a really good day. That logo can only mean great things. Hello, everyone. Today we begin Let's Play Vanquish. All you need to know about Vanquish is that it was made by Platinum, and it was directed by none other than Shinji Mikami, and it shits on the third-person shooter genre from great, great heights. It is the undisputed, unquestionable king of the hill of this genre. Yes, 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 indeed. And I do not say that lightly, because Shinji Mikami also made the other greatest third-person shooter ever, Resident Evil 4. The man's legacy should tell you everything you need to know about this. The father of Resident Evil, of Dino Crisis, of God Hand, all games that are going to or have shown up on the channel at some point because they are so awesome.
Vanquish.
Vanquish is on another plane. It is the only third-person shooter that I would also call a character action game. If you cross Resident Evil 4 with a bit of Bayonetta, you get an idea of what you're in for. Just a glimpse, just a glimmer. The box art for this game is your character in his exo-suit shooting while rocket sliding so fast that the entire world is a blurry streak. That is what you're in for. We're gonna get in there. I don't need to go through this tutorial, but gotta sit here for just a second for the beginning of it. You won't be hearing from me for a little while because the opening to this game is pretty long. The rest of the game is basically all action all the time. The opening cutscene is obscenely long, though. So, you can't skip the tutorial until you go through the little, like, is your camera control, are your camera controls right? Are they inverted? Do you want them inverted? All that's bullshit. I'm gonna skip ahead to the opening cutscene. So you'll be hearing from me in about 15 minutes.
Thank you.
The Order of the Russian Star now welcomes you to the inauguration of a new Russian state.
My order is now the only authority in Russia. In 10 hours, we exercise our newfound strength once again.
There is but one way to prevent the destruction of
New York City.
Your complete and unconditional surrender.
My fellow Americans, today has been a day of great tragedy. San Francisco will never be the same. And the toll of our war has increased by countless men, women, and children. Their loss is deeply felt by every American. To those who have committed this heinous act, we say firmly, we will not negotiate with those who wish to destroy us. Our strength is unmatched, our will resolute. We will be victorious. God bless you all, and God bless the United States of America.
SCO-1 Providence is currently under the control of those responsible for the coup in Moscow. We believe the operation is being led by a Red known as Zaitsev. Oh yeah, this is Sam. DARPA sent him to come along with us. Men, we've got 8 hours to stop New York from becoming the next San Francisco. Make no mistake, we will stop that from happening.
Yes, sir!
Sam, I'm not sure if you've noticed, but your new friends don't seem too fond of you.
DARPA operatives take their orders directly from POTUS and SecDef. These guys are just interested in marking their territory.
Sam, remember why we're here.
Get the professor back. This place, hell, even this suit runs on his energy designs. He's too valuable to kill.
I know.
This the toy you've been working on? Not even scratched. You did get some training in this thing, right?
Our simulators are very thorough. They did quite a number on you, huh? We could use you as a test subject at DARPA. What the fuck, man?
Not allowed to smoke on the ship.
Who's smoking aloud, motherfucker? Don't get too excited just yet. The intro's not quite done. We're gonna have part two cutscene boogaloo in just a second. While I have control, though, here's the major gist of the gameplay. It all revolves around what Sam's suit can do and your weapons. There are 8 weapon types and 2 grenade types. You can have 3 weapons and 2 grenades at a time. Here's the big one. Here's rocket sliding. You can boost and rocket slide all around. It's tied to the green meter in the bottom right. If you drain it, you overheat and you lose mobility. And you can also dodge roll assisted by the suit and the boost. You can also activate AR mode, which is slow-mo, for a short period of time. It also depends on that green meter. You can go into AR after a dodge roll or during boosts. And the other way that you go into slow motion is if you take critical damage on your suit. You don't have the health bar in this, it's just your suit's AR meter. So you take critical damage, you go into AR mode and overheat for a little bit. If you take critical damage while you're overheated, you die. That's the core of it. Oh my god, let's go! Let's go! Even though that opening cutscene is like 15 minutes long, I watch that every time because it's so good, it gets me so pumped. It sets this chaos up perfectly! Oh, by the way, right behind you is the first Pangloss statue. They're little collectibles for you to shoot. They're pretty well hidden, they're all over the place. I'm not gonna be getting them. Definitely not all of them. I just want to let you know they exist. But, like, the chaos, that cutscene, the music is so thumping in high tempo, and it tells you right away that these villains are scum! They are not messing around! It gets you so ready! Oh my god, I love this game! Oh, alright, there's so much to comment on in that intro. I feel kind of paralyzed. This game, man, it's so dense, everything. In the best way possible. Oh, shit. So in a second here, let me shoot some of these gorgies. Or gorgies, is that what they're called? Gorgies? Can't remember how to pronounce it. Okay, look off into the distance. Even the scenery, the background is dense. But it's dense with stuff that's actually being rendered, stuff that's actually going on. Those ships are heading towards you. That ship's going down. Just a hail of salvos of bullets and ships and all this stuff going on. Oh, yeah. The scenery is amazing here. Chaos unfolding everywhere. Just explosions, giant sci-fi battleships duking it out. It's all dynamic too. You could kill the Gorgie up here and hijack its... Oh, what is this even called? This big strider. Just to clear out this room in here. It's very, very cool. Oh, shit. I guess I'll talk a little bit about that intro in just a second. We're gonna have a short little interlude here after we're done collecting weapons that are scattered around and crates. The green dots on the mini-map are crates, white dots are dropped weapons. You wanna go around, and even if you're at full ammo, especially if you're at full ammo, collect all the ammo pickups, because when you're at full ammo on a weapon and you pick ammo for that type up, you get a chevron over that weapon's logo. And when you get 3 chevrons, that weapon becomes upgraded. And there are 10 upgrade levels total. They affect things like the ammo capacity, the damage, all that stuff.
The arrivals plaza for landing bay 3 is up ahead.
We've got heavy fighting in the plaza. Bravo, move forward but maintain cover.
Roger that. Guess it's time for the real thing.
Your suit is performing at nominal levels, Sam.
Never had a girl say that to me before.
So I forgot to mention about the melee. Every single weapon type, all 8 of them, have distinct, unique melees. And even your boost has its own melee. So if you hit the melee button while in boost, you do that flying kick. Which you can use that against a wall or an object or something to kind of fly into the air. And you could go into slow motion up there, just in midair. It's actually really helpful to get position on certain enemies who are behind cover in certain situations. Everything has some kind of use in this. Also, enemies randomly drop either grenades, random ammo pickups, or they can also drop straight-up upgrades for whatever your currently equipped weapon is. Alright, up here, we're about to get our first... Hold on, after I get that heavy machine gun... Up here, we got our first new weapon type. This is the sniper rifle. Our initial weapons are pretty standard. It's a sniper rifle, an assault rifle, a heavy machine gun, and a shotgun. There are a couple very unique weapon types coming up later. Oh, shit, that Gorgie's getting ready to explode. They, if they take critical damage, but you don't finish them off, they'll start leaping around with their cores trying to latch onto you and explode on for an instant kill. Okay, I could snipe a couple things from up here. There's some dudes riding striders, there's some dudes manning turrets. I'm gonna take care of those. Alright, let's go back to the opening cutscene because there is so much going on in there. So that was the grimmest opening. This is a dire science fiction game. Despite the fact that it's so fun, it's actually very grim in its story. So energy and resources are running out around the world. The U.S. launches a space station into orbit that can provide solar energy to America. Meanwhile, Russian nationalists, the Order of the Russian Star, launch a successful coup in Russia. They take over the military. They somehow hijack the space station and use it to microwave San Francisco. For what a, like, that's the darkest opening. Of course, the whole story is hot bullshit. And most of it's just because Mikami was like, I thought the Russians would be cool villains, even though it's a cliche because Cold War nostalgia.
Sam, we're picking up some sort of interference on the scanners. Looks temporal.
You think they're zapping something in?
We're about to have enemies warping in, so I'm going to time a grenade toss. So, no, I threw a little bit too early. Could have got all of them at once. Oop, I've taken critical damage because I was too close. And I'm now in automatic AR mode. So my suit's going to overheat in a second. If I take critical damage again, I will die. So let me chill behind cover for just a sec. Okay, back to the story. Yeah, that's a bizarre phrase. Two phrases to put together. Cold War and nostalgia. And then the other part of it is, like, San Francisco getting microwaved, and that's just because Mikami really wanted to see the Golden Gate Bridge get destroyed. Literally, that's the whole reason. Word for word from an interview he did. I just thought it'd be cool to destroy the Golden Gate Bridge.
It looks like you're just going to have to fight through this one.
All right, so we'll collect some stuff around the battlefield, get ready to meet some new enemy types again.
The gate's open now.
Let me man this for what's coming up, because there's a big choke point right here on the stairs. I can... Yeah, I'm fast enough. Good. Our hero Sam is clearly what Jetstream Sam, the villain from Platinum's Metal Gear Rising, is based on. And the president is very obviously supposed to be Hillary Clinton. But by far the coolest thing from the intro happened way before the cutscenes even started. When Vanquish's logo first appeared on screen. Ah, damn it. Hold on.
The main gate is above you. You need to get up there and open it.
Burns, I need some backup.
Franklin, Rios, you two escort Sam. Everyone else, provide cover.
Okay, I was saying that when Vanquish's logo first appears on the screen in the very beginning, on the menu screen, you could see that the Q is designed after something very specific, the Q in the Vanquish logo. It's designed after something called a Lagrangian point. A Lagrange point is a specific point in space between two bodies where the gravitational pull of those two bodies balance each other out in such a way that you could launch, say, a satellite, or in the case of this game, a space station, and have it orbit perfectly in geosynchronous orbit with the Earth over one specific point. In this case, the space station is in orbit, so it is always directly over the U.S. That's why the Q in Vanquish is a Lagrange point. Oh, that's so fucking cool. Alright, let me boost up here, roll up here, get out of danger. I was trying to pick as many of them off with grenades as possible. You're on a little bit of a timer here before the next event happens, so you want to try to clear as many Gorgies out as possible. I think that's what they're called. It's definitely G-O-R-G-I-S. I don't know if you're supposed to say Gorgies or Georgies or what. Gorgy sounds so much like Corgi to me, though.
A heat source is coming up from within the substructure.
Need a bit more intel than that.
Data analysis complete. It's highly probable we're looking at the Russian KNRB-0 Argus robot that's been at the center of the arms control fleet.
Oh, shit. I think I'm gonna need a bigger gun.
It's a monocoque design. They sacrificed armor for payload capacity, so the outer shell should have some strength issues.
Motherfucker! I'd rather go all out than bother with defense. Time to hit hard and make him regret it.
We got our first boss fight against the Argus. This thing is nothing but weapons. It's a giant... it's fucking literally a giant enemy crab, except it's totally made out of guns. It's barely armored. So shooting the red core is the only way to bring its health bar down, but you could stun it for a little bit by shooting its yellow glowing legs. And I like to hang out down here for the first half of this boss fight, because you get a lot of open space, and you actually get a decent amount of cover down here. If it would scuttle its ass more towards the back of this arena from where I'm at, I would chill more around that central plaza. But we'll blow the legs out, and then that gives us a good opening to switch over to the heavy machine gun and start really going to work on the core. Yeah, the window of opportunity is not huge, but you can see you do a lot of damage with that heavy machine gun, especially if you're up close. It's not really accurate, but it's... as far as the punch, the power of it goes, it's, I think, the strongest gun in the game. Just not very accurate from a range. There are still Gorgies around here, so let me go and try to pick them off without getting dominated by that. There's this sound that telegraphs that missile. It sounds like a guitar riff. Plus, you see the cannon start glowing like that, so you can just dodge out of the way. When it has its attention on you, it's actually a good opportunity to just straight up shoot it without even having to stun it. Sometimes your AI fodder teammates will just draw his fire away. Can't really get to the core from that, but it's a good chance to shoot its legs and get ready to stun it. So that's the first half of the fight. For the next half, I'm going to go up top where the turrets were. And we're going to see something fucking amazing. This is like the chopper in Half-Life 2 when you blow it up. Except way more badass!
It initiated its transformation. Most likely to connect to its generator and fire its large radius laser.
It turns into a fucking Gundam. drills for hands. Oh, it's like a Pacific Rim robot more than a Gundam. Let's see if I can maybe take the arm out before it starts firing lasers. Ah, now it's gonna get the lasers off. Let me pay attention to those. Okay. That one comes vertically. I think the next one too. Yeah, got caught a little bit. Tag. Alright, now this is just free damage on the arm. Something very cool happens when you blow its left arm up. I don't think it happens for any other part of its body. You can blow basically everything on its body up. His head, his back, his legs, his arms. But his left arm in particular, you get to do this. Right stick. And then I think the other, it's counterclockwise and then clockwise again.
Fuck yeah!
Oh god, this game makes me feel like a kid! It's the best feeling in the world! Alright, quick reload. That's a trick I'll talk about more probably later when I have a little bit more breathing room.
Everyone fire on that core!
This game wouldn't be the same without the music, man. The music's so high tempo. It's so fast and aggressive. It's a little bit like a Hollywood score, but it's also a little techno. Shit, I'm trying to get a good angle on this in slow motion. Guess not. Okay. So we'll use a little bit more ammo in the heavy machine gun just to weaken the arms. Because the real damage right now is gonna come from the turrets if I can get its core exposed in the right spot. Which I think I have a good opening to do in a second. Where is that turret? It's over here on the right. Can I get to it in time? Yeah. Look how much damage this turret's gonna do. Bam! Oh, like melted butter. I think the phrase I was going for there was a hot knife through butter, but that's what came out. Holy shit, this game is good. Thumping soundtrack. Love it. Love everything about this game. There's nothing wrong with it.
Well done.
If you say so.
No time for pissing in the wind. Let's go.
Oh, there's always time to piss in the wind.
Gladly.
Okay.
I've opened the main gate.
Bravo, advance through the gate. Keep it closed until reinforcements arrive.
You can see by the number of stars on my heavy machine gun, that's the one at the top, that I already have it at level 2. I have my shotgun at level 1. And I'm going to try to avoid upgrading the assault rifle because I'm not going to keep it around that long. I'm going to switch between probably the assault rifle, the disc launcher, and a few other weapons. Alright, I've collected everything. Scour the battlefield. Let's move on and...